The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd Canto, 25th Chapter, text number 42, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 10th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
It is because of my supremacy that the wind blows out of fear of me, the sun shines out of fear of me. The Lord of the clouds, Indra, sends forth showers out of fear of me. The fire burns out of fear of me, and death goes about taking its toll out of fear of me.
Madhvayat bhati bhatoyam sujjas tapati madhvayat barsati Indra dahati agni. Mittuscharati madhvaya. The ultimate. Mittuscharati madhvaya. So, bhaya. Bhaya means fearfulness. Vayang dityabhi niveshatasya. In the previous verse, the Lord Kapildev said that if anyone wants to get out of this fearful situation, bhayang tibram nivartate, atmana sarva bhutana bhayang tibram nivartate. We are always fearful. Material life is not very happy life, because we are always fearful. That's a fact. Nobody can say, no, I am not afraid of anything. That is false. Everyone is afraid of something. Everyone. Bird, beast, human being, everyone. Bhayang dityami nivishatashyat. Because we have got absorption in the second category of life. Second category means this bodily conception of life. Ditya abhinivesh. I am thinking at the present moment that I am this body. Everyone is thinking. Therefore, when there is fear of destruction of this body, we become very much afraid, perplexed. We have seen in Los Angeles there was earthquake, and all the neighborhood women especially began to scream, fearful, now death is coming. So everyone is afraid. This is the material nature. Ahar, nidra, bhoy, maithun. Four things. Material wants. Eating, sleeping, fearing, and defending. So, Krishna said that if you want to, Kapildev and Krishna are the same. Krishna has many forms. Kapildev is one of the forms. Abhesh Avatar. There are many incarnations. Krishna is the original personality of Godhead. In the Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a list of different avatars. And the conclusion, Lord Buddha's also name is there. Kikiteshu Bhavishyati, Surat Visham, so, Lord Buddha's name is there, and Jayadev has also given his poem, Dasavida, Dasa Avatar Stotra. In that Dasa Avatar also, Lord Buddha's name is there. Kesavadhrita Buddha Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hare. So, Vaishnava, they know by the grace of Krishna How many avatars are there? They do not accept that for any bogus avatar. Some rascal would say that I am avatar. The Vaishnava will not accept. Tasmat shastra vidhanoktam. The Bhagavad Gita says, shastra vidhanoktam. Karjakar. We have to accept and reject according to the shastra. Not that any bogus man comes and says that I am avatar. That is not acceptable. The Vaishnava will not accept. A policeman may accept. That is a different thing. So, certainly, the Supreme Personality has got many avatars. But each avatar has been mentioned in the shastras. Different avatars. So Kapil Dev is avatar. Therefore, he is saying, me, Madhvayat, Madhvayat. So, Madhvayat Bhati Bhatubhuyam. These are the very strong sources of fearfulness. If there is cyclone, it is very fearful. It is going on very nicely, but if it is a big cyclone, then it is fearful. So there is necessity of cyclone also. There is necessity of scorching heat. There is necessity of rainfall. So there are different directors and officers, and they are all a servant of Krishna. Therefore, Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Ikula Ishar Krishna Arasa Vritta. The only master, supreme master, is Krishna. And all others, they are Vritta, servant. The demigods, they are all servants of Krishna. Demigods, they are. Surya, Chandra, Vayu, Varun, Brihaspati, so many, 33 crores of demigods. They have got different planets. But all of them are servants of Krishna. Mayat dhakshena prakriti suyati sa characharam. The modern so-called scientists, they say there is no demigod, there is no god. This is all natural function, that's all right. Nature is working. But nature is matter. Matter cannot work without the direction of the living being. You cannot say matter works independently. That is not possible. Everything is that's why here it is said, now we have got experience in the beach, there is always big waves. That water is also dull matter, and the air pushing the dull matter, water, and there is big waves, and it is dashing on the earth. These things are going on. So they say it is nature's work. But nature is not independent. We get this information from authoritative shastra. Here, Kapil Dev says that there is high wind that is due to the command Madhvayat Bhati Bhatu. High wind is there. Sometimes there is breezy, very nice. Sometimes very high wind. So, there is direction. You cannot say that is automatically happening. No. There is direction. Krishna says that mayadhakshena prakriti syate sa characharam. Under my superintendence, prakriti, nature, the scientists, they say nature is working wonderfully. But after all, nature is not under your control. That you have to accept. You may defy Krishna or God, but you cannot defy the nature's activities. You are subordinate. But because you do not know the background of nature, therefore we think that nature is working, there is no God. But that is not fair. Nature is working under the direction. This is atheism. One who knows. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that this natural, ingredients, prakriti, jara prakriti, or material nature, five elements, kiti of tej marut bomb, this marut, bayu, and tej, this sunshine, kiti of tej, and water, the seas and oceans, the land, vast land, kiti of tej marut bomb, and then sky, they are different manifestation of Krishna's external energy. They are not independent. There are many shastras, therefore one has to consult the shastras. In the Brahma Sanghita it is also said, the material nature is very powerful. Srishti sthiti pralaya sadhana shaktiri ka. The material nature is so powerful that it can create srishti, sthiti, it can maintain and it can destroy also. Srishti sthiti pralaya sadhana. It is so powerful. It can do that. Srishti sthiti pralaya sadhana shaktiri ka. But how the material nature is working? Chayeva jasya vibhakti bhuvanani durga. The material nature is working just like shadow. Shadow. If you have got this real hand and there is shadow, if you move your hand, the shadow of the hand also moves. Similarly, this material nature is working in touch with the spirit soul. It's like big pilot is flying in the sky. You have got experience. But it is not independently flying. There is the pilot. He is pushing the button and it is flying. A big car, big machine, big factory, without touch of spiritual task, there is no question of moving. You have got this practical experience. Where is the evidence that without the touch of spirit soul, that machine is moving? Is there any evidence? Then how you can say that without God, the whole universe is moving? There is no evidence. We have no such experience. Then how you can say that without the direction of God, the material nature can move? There is no such experience. And from the evidences of Shastra, here it is said, the wind is blowing, the water is moving, the sun is giving scorching heat, everything. All under the direction of the Supreme Personality of God. Not only that direction, but it is said bhayat. Bhayat. Bhayat means if the respective directors or agents of different material elements, if they do not work properly, then he is punished as the master punishes the servant. Mayad dhakshina. When Krishna was present, there was Giridhari. Giridhari, he lifted the mountain, Govardhan Hill, Govardhana, the Dhari. So, Nanda Maharaj was arranging to worship the Indra, Indra Yajna. There are different kinds of yajna. But Indra Dev was a little proud that he is all in all. Everyone thinks if he is in power, then he tries to give some trouble to others. Similarly, all the demigods, they are, if they are not satisfied, they will give you trouble. The Indra Yajna is there, but Krishna said to his father, "My dear father, there is no need of Indra Yajna. You better worship Govardhan Hill. He is symbolical presentation of God, because the cows, they get their food, grasses. The better you make this Govardhan Yajna." So first of all, Nanda Maharaj was not willing, but out of the affection of Krishna, that is devotee. Devotees of Krishna, they are acting always in love for Krishna. So Nanda Maharaj changed his idea of worshipping Indra. Rather, on the contrary, all the ingredients he collected, he worshipped the Govardhan Hill and stopped Indra Yajna. So Indra became very much angry, and he sent the vicious cloud, and whole Vrindavan was inundated by flood. And Krishna saw that your power is not even competent to compare with the finger of my hand. Therefore, he lifted the Govardhan Hill with the finger of his left hand and saved all the people of Vrindavan. Then Indra came to worship him. These things are there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So everyone is servant. You do not... You can perform yajna for ordinarily, but if you be simply under the shelter of Krishna, you do not require to perform different demigod yajnas, deva yajna. That is not required. The example is given that if you pour water in the root of the tree, you do not require to pour water in the branches, in the twigs, in the flowers, in the fruits. It is automatically done. If you supply food to the stomach, then you do not require to feed the eyes, hands, legs separately. There is no need. Neither it is possible to give separate food, materials for nourishing the different parts of the body. One place is sufficient. Similarly, if we worship Krishna, the source of everything, the root of everything, aham adirhi jagyanam divanam divajagya. So Krishna says that you don't require to perform different yajnas. That is not possible in this age especially. It requires large amount of wealth to perform such yajnas. Nowadays people are suffering for want of sufficient food grains, and in this yajna, tons and thousands of months of food grains are offered in the fire. That is good. But there is no food grain, there is no ghee. That is not possible in this age. Therefore, yajna is not possible. You can perform very easily the sankirtan yajna. Then everything will be performed. Yajnai sankirtanai prai jajanti hi sumeras. Those who are intelligent person, they can perform yajna, sankirtan yajna. This is recommended in this age. Other yajnas is not possible. Kriti dadhyato Vishnu tritayam jajato mukhai. Trita Yam. Yoga performance was very prominent in the Trita Yuga at that time. But at present moment, it is not possible. Dhyana Yoga, Drabha Yoga, Jnana Yoga, and Sankirtan Yoga. So in this age, Sankirtan Yoga is recommended. Yagyai Sankirtanai Prayai Jajantihi Sumedhas. Sumedhas, and those who have got good brain. And it is so easy, anywhere you can perform. Any part of the world, you assemble together. Sankirtan means bahumi militva, by intermingling various persons. Just like we are doing here. Sankirtan. Kirtan and Sankirtan. Kirtan means alone, and Sankirtan means in the assembly of many others. That is called Sankirtan. That is recommended. That many persons, you sit together, there is no need of even an instrument, but because Lord Chaitanya introduced this whole kartal, otherwise this clapping is sufficient. So it is very easy. Sankirtan Yagga. You sit down, family-wise, all the family members, if you perform Sankirtan, Hare Krishna, Mahamantra, with the clapping of hands, there is Sankirtan Yagga. Very easy to perform. The people will not do that. Instead of performing Sankirtan Yagga in the evening, to become free from all fears of life, they will go to the restaurant, to the cinema, and other places, talking unnecessarily in clubs, societies, waste their time. This is going on. This is modern education. This is modern civilization. They are not aware of the tibram bhayam, the most fearful situation of birth, death, old age and disease. This is the opportunity, the human life, how to get out of it. The means are there, but we are so fools, we are so foolishly educated in the name of modern civilization that we neglect all these things and we place ourselves in the waves of the material nature. Mayar vase jachcha bhese khachcha havuru. You are being carried away by the waves of this material nature. And we have submitted to the laws of material nature. And therefore we are subjected to birth, death, old age and disease. And not only birth, there is no guarantee what kind of birth next life. So we should not misuse this labdha sudullamamidam bahusam bhavanti manasam. We should not waste our this valuable life, human form of life. We begin our this evolution. First of all, the world is covered with water. Pralaya payadhijale dhitavanasi bidam. Now still, the 3/4 of this earthly planet is covered with water. In the beginning, there was the whole earthly planet was covered with water. Gradually, the water is drying up and the land is coming. Then we are calculating this is Asia, this is America, this is in Europe, and land is coming out. And gradually, Land, there will be only land, no water. That means destruction. When there will be no water and scorching heat, the whole earthly planet will be ablaze and everything will be burned into ashes. Then again there will be rainfall and everything will be mixed up, and then again there will be destruction. This is going on. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. And similarly, our position with this body, this will be also dissolved again. These nice form you have got, I have got, but when it is finished, this is finished forever. You are not going to get any more. You will get different body, not exactly this body. It is bubble, one bubble lost, that is lost forever. That is lost forever. But we are so foolish, we are thinking this is permanent settlement. Permanent settlement. This is called ignorance. There is no question of permanent settlement. Temporary under the prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa, under the laws of nature, you are getting different types of bodies, different types of opportunities, and it is going on. But we are spirit soul. We are not this material body. So we must have sense and take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead to save ourselves from this material condition of life, repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. And if you think, when Krishna says that you surrender unto me, I will give you protection. So because we are foolish, we think Krishna as ordinary human being. Abhijananti manga mura. Manasim tanumasa. Because we are murhas, rascals, we think that Krishna is a person like us. Manasim. Krishna is very kind. He comes to be visible by us exactly in the same way as we are. Manasam tanum. But we think when Krishna comes, he is a man. He is a man like us. God is different. Abhijananti manga mura. Because we are muras. Parambhava abhijananta. So they do not know what is Krishna. Therefore, when Krishna demands sarvadharman parityajya mamek saranam vajana, we foolish people, we think, it is too much. Krishna is so proud that he is commanding us that you surrender unto me. So I am not so fool. I am not going to do that. This is the position. Murha. Because murha, they are taking Krishna as ordinary human being. Because he is so kind, he comes as human being and gives you the right information, right instruction. But we are so rascal that we do not accept it. Do not accept it. That is our misfortune. Those who are fortunate enough, they accept Krishna. Bhunam janmanavanti, gyanavan maam bhagavata. That fortune comes not so easily. After struggling, after associating with Vaishnava, with devotees, after cultivating knowledge for many, many births. So, we should take the chance. We should not be foolish. Don't be foolish. Mura. Just surrender to Krishna and execute Krishna's service, what Krishna says. Do that, you'll be saved. You'll be saved from these clutches of maya, repetition of birth and death. Even if you fall down, if you do not be able to execute devotional service fully, still you will get next chance as a human being. Suchinang simatangehi yuga bhrashta sanjayati. You will get again chance of this human body. But if you don't take Krishna consciousness, then there is no guarantee. You can become next life, cat, dog, tree or anything, according to the infection and quality. But if you become Krishna conscious, and if you give even little service to Krishna, your next life as human being is guaranteed. And that is not ordinary human life. Suchinang simatangihi. Tattva sadhanmam charanambujam hare bhajanna pakkoto patittato jati. Narad Muni said that if one engages himself in devotional service out of sentiment, it doesn't matter. Still, If he does some service to Krishna, then he is gainer. And one who is very practical, does not take to Krishna consciousness and take to material activities and thinks that he is very advanced, there is no gain. He is under karma. According karma, he will get body. But a Krishna conscious human being, even though he is unable to execute properly, even if he falls down, his human life is guaranteed. His human life is guaranteed. And that life in a rich family and in very nice, purified family, Suchinang. Suchinang means purified family, nice Brahman Vaishnava family. Or Srimatang. Sri means opulence. Those who are possessing opulence means big mercantile family, big rich family, or big nice Brahman Vaishnava family. You get again chance, just like the children of this Krishna conscious members, from childhood they are getting this boy, Mr. West, he is getting chance to worship Krishna. So this is Suchinang, Srimatangi. How he satisfies. There are so many children in our Krishna consciousness movement. From the very beginning of life, they have got chance for chanting Hare Krishna, attending Mangalaritri, taking prasadam, and reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. Life is success. Just see. So we are, after giving chance to the bewildered persons, misled person, materialistic person, to take up this Krishna consciousness movement, and their success is guaranteed. Because Krishna says, Aham tva sarva papibha mokkhayishyami. If you think Krishna is ordinary person, how? Therefore Krishna says that don't think me that I am ordinary person. Under my direction, the wind is blowing, the sea is working, the sun is hitting, and so many things are going on. Maya, Thakshina, Prakriti. Don't take me so slightly. Everything is explained. Now it is our business to accept it or not accept. Thank you very much.